Welcome to the red realm of Mars, where two small enigmatic moons orbit the fourth planet from the Sun. These celestial companions, Phobos and Deimos, may be diminutive in size, but they hold a wealth of mystery and intrigue that continues to captivate scientists and space enthusiasts alike. Phobos and Deimos were discovered by American astronomer Asaph Hall on August 12th and August 18th, 1877. Named after the mythological sons of Ares, the Greek god of war, these small moons play a crucial role in our ongoing efforts to understand the Martian system. Phobos, the larger of the two moons, has a diameter of about 22 kilometers, while Deimos is slightly smaller at around 12 kilometers across. Here's a comparison of Phobos, Deimos, and our moon. You can see how small Phobos and Deimos are next to our moon. Phobos orbits Mars at an average distance of just 6,000 kilometers, making it one of the closest moons to its parent planet in the entire solar system. Deimos, on the other hand, orbits at a greater distance of about 20,000 kilometers. Phobos completes an orbit around Mars in just under 7.7 hours, making it the fastest orbiting moon known, while Deimos takes about 30.3 hours to complete its orbit. Both moons have irregular shapes and are covered in a thick layer of dust and debris, giving them a rugged appearance. Phobos's surface is scarred by numerous grooves and large craters, including the enormous Stickney crater, which is a dominant feature on the moon's surface. Deimos, in contrast, has a smoother appearance with fewer prominent craters. One of the most intriguing aspects of Phobos is its rapid orbital decay. Due to tidal forces exerted by Mars, Phobos is gradually spiraling inward, nearing the planet at a rate of 6 feet, 1.8 meters, every 100 years. At this rate, the moon is on a collision course with Mars and will either crash into the planet or break apart into a ring system in about 50 million years. Deimos, while more stable in its orbit, exhibits interesting features as well. Its surface is covered with a layer of fine dust, which has led to a smoother appearance compared to Phobos. The low gravity on Deimos allows for a unique landscape, with the potential for interesting geological studies if future missions visit this moon. Both Phobos and Deimos are thought to be captured asteroids or remnants of larger bodies, giving them a different origin story compared to many other moons in our solar system. Their composition, primarily made up of carbon-rich rock and ice, contributes to their dark, reflective surfaces. Our knowledge of Phobos and Deimos has been shaped by several key missions. Mariner 9, arriving to Mars in 1971, was the first to capture close-up images of these moons. Fun fact about Mariner 9, its final transmission was on October 27, 1972, and its exact fate is still unknown. It might still be orbiting Mars, or it could have burned up or crashed on the surface. While there are no scheduled missions for Phobos and Deimos, future Mars explorations could reveal more about these moons and their role in the Martian system. If you found our exploration of Phobos and Deimos as fascinating as we did, don't forget to like and subscribe for the latest updates on space exploration. Share your thoughts and questions in the comments below. Your curiosity drives our quest for knowledge. Stay curious, and thank you for joining us on this cosmic journey.